Monumental changes are coming to America by way of the sea. They come by way of larger vessels and heavier maritime traffic, shipping the nation's cargo. They come by expanding forays into offshore energy and aquaculture. They come by the heightened urgency to restore and protect coastlines and ocean habitats, and from the mounting needs of our armed forces to defend them all. From Maine to Virginia, seaward 200 miles, an unprecedented collaboration of federal and state agencies and Native American tribes are working with new ocean data and extensive stakeholder input to keep national security strong, the economy growing, and to protect vital ocean habitat. This is the new blue economy of the 21st century.
Ocean planning fits very well with the Coast Guard's approach. It's critical for the Coast Guard and other agencies to work together in a collaborative manner to ensure the maritime transportation system is safe, secure, efficient, and resilient.
Four of the busiest ports in the nation are found along the mid-Atlantic coast, shipping and receiving more than 200 million metric tons of cargo. New York's harbor alone accounts for approximately $200 billion in trade each year.
And you can see right away that the prosperity of our nation is inextricably connected to maritime commerce and the safe flow of this commerce into these ports.
The Panama Canal has been expanded, the Suez Canal has been expanded, which very much affects ports around the country and especially on the East Coast. The industry is moving very fast and the ships will continue to get larger. And I think that's the main takeaway, is that ports will have to accommodate larger vessels or they'll be left behind. The whole point of this regional planning body is for every entity at the table to work together to maintain, you know, a healthy ocean ecosystem, sustainable ocean uses, because we've found that, you know, going off and working in a vacuum just isn't going to get it done for these pressing challenges in the 21st century.
There are commercial interests, there's national security interests, and there's also conservation interests. In addition to that, you also have the largest naval installation in the world. All this is in the same area where we have wind energy being pursued, hydrokinetic energy is being pursued, an expansion of the shipping lanes associated with the Panama Canal expansion is happening. The Navy has a critical role in national defense in protecting the ocean highways and the global economy. So what the ocean plans enable you to do is it provides an avenue, it provides a mechanism, and it provides a process by which stakeholders, whether they be commercial interests, national security interests, commercial fishermen, recreational fishermen, the conservation groups, have the same information that's going into the decision-making process through the use of the Mid-Atlantic or the Northeast regional data portals. Data is the key for understanding the decisions that are being made regarding the ocean.
I think there's a common misconception that this whole ocean policy is more of a Democrat, more of an Obama administration thing, but it was the Bush administration that put together this Commission on Oceans. They recommended very clearly that we needed some sort of coordinated ocean policy to deal with that sort of thing. You know, with that said, this is a public resource we're talking about. The oceans are public, and all stakeholders, all interests need to have input into that process. We need to be heard, and we really need to engage. And ocean planning is really providing us that opportunity to be part of it.
We're seeing changes in water temperature in this region that are greater than any other place really in the world. And as the ocean conditions change, we're going to see species, fish species, aquatic resources that we manage moving as well. And so it's really a critical element to making sure that our commercial and recreational fisheries are maintained while there are these shifts in the populations for which we manage, and all of these other human uses of the ocean, you know, develop.
So we've seen that just in the process of creating the plan, having people together at the table for the first time, we have shipping industry people better understanding what the fishermen need, and energy people better understanding what the military needs. And this just has never happened before in our country.
This, in many ways, is about the rights of states. This is very much about states' rights. This is about states being able to sit as equals at the table with the feds and saying, these are our concerns. You need to hear us. We need to address them. And that, I think, is vitally important as well.